Hi folks, welcome back to F122. So quick change, or quick, just to let you know, I have fixed the steering wheel on this game. It's been a long time since I've used the wheel on F1. I think it was like halfway through the first season of 2021 is the last time I used the wheel. The reason I stopped is because I just couldn't get it to work properly, but I've got it to a somewhat working sensitivity that I'm used to, so we'll give it a go in the next race, which is actually one of the worst races for me personally, the Monaco Grand Prix. So we'll see how it works, we'll see how it goes. So hopefully the steering's a bit better. I've adjusted the brake pedal because it was never right before. It just wouldn't brake properly, it wasn't strong enough. I was like outbreaking myself and stuff, but hopefully it'll work. Anyway, all that out of the way, enjoy the Monaco Grand Prix. I'll do what I can. If you remember from the last season, we ended up retiring from it because I just couldn't be bothered with it. But we'll try it today. We've got a much better car, as you can see. So we'll go for it.
ready for tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who'll be fronting the grid. Coulthard, Fernando Alonso, and Charles Leclerc. A proper road race, and in the true meaning of the word. That's how Mr. Monaco, the late great Graham Hill, once described this iconic event. The cars we drive have come a long way in the intervening half century, but still we race on those same public roads beside the Mediterranean. There's no victory more coveted than that of the Monaco Grand Prix. The prestigious Circuit de Monaco, then, is not all that dissimilar today to the layout that made its debut almost a century ago. It's 2 miles and 19 corners through the streets of Monte Carlo. And although the average lap speed of around 93 miles per hour is the lowest of the season, the tiny margins for error make it the natural habitat of the safety car. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. David Coulthard lines up on pole position, with Charles Leclerc alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Russell, Norris, Carlos Sainz, and Verstappen. Fernando Alonso, they'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. Hamilton, Perez, and Esteban Ocon. Magnussen, Oscar Piastri, Sebastian Vettel, and Gasly. Mick Schumacher, Tsunoda, Alex Albon, and Lance Stroll. Schwartzman, Latifi, Joe, and Smith. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today?
After the points finished last race, let's aim to keep that momentum going. Okay, now stay alert with the rest around you. Seconds. the car in front is 13.3 seconds. Last of the running cars right now. Roll is ahead of you. Okay, gap ahead is 16.3 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. There's a new strategy available on the MFD. Coming to fit the mediums. Car ahead now running medium tyres. right now, focus on the race. We're currently trailing our teammate by 46.2 seconds. They're on old mediums. They're in first. Our flat time was a 1:17.2. Okay, we're approaching the pit window. You're going to be on stop. Okay, gap to the car ahead is 13.5 seconds. David in the pits. Okay, be aware, the grip levels are going to start falling away soon. Okay, we want you to pit this lap, so push now, push. Ahead of you just fitted the hard tyres. Car ahead now on the hard compound. And gap to the car in front is 23.3 seconds. Late turning meant we had a slower than planned pit stop, I'm afraid. Look after these tyres now, we want to finish the race on this compound. Okay, gap ahead is 44.0 seconds. about the tyre condition for now. Everything's looking good.
To win, and they've only gone and done it. What a fantastic result here at Monaco. Anthony, tell me, what was it that helped them achieve this success?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs, and that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximize the strategy, and to stay out of trouble.
Exhausted after the excitement of that race, but I'm sure it's nothing compared to our drivers here. They've worked hard to make it up there, and it's great to see them make their way onto the podium now. Not the result our points leader would have wanted, but it certainly makes things interesting going forward. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. Some amazing talent out on the track today, but Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
I think for driver of the day, I'd probably pick Lando Norris. He lived up to every inch of his reputation today, and I think he'll be going home, quite rightly, a bit proud of himself.
Well, what can you say? That I knew I wasn't going to do well. I never do well in Monaco, but I didn't expect to get lapped by my teammate on hards. There are no words for that race. There are no words. I just have no pace on that track. At all. Anyway, we've got some upgrades hopefully coming soon.
Is asking who you see as your rival.
Be Leclerc, I would say. Come on. Hate it when it does this. Just yes. Enter. Go, do it. This bit takes forever, I don't know why.
Thanks for stepping in and helping handle that.
Right. I'm just going to renew them because they are fine. Fingers crossed. I've got my fingers crossed here. All of them go through. Yes. Perfect. Completed without issue. They'll be on the car ready for the next race weekend. Oh, look at that. Aero is right up now. So we've got new parts in here. I think that's all of them actually. Yeah, there's only one left. I don't think we've got access to anything here yet, have we? Spec 3. No. We'll try and get durability now. At least we've got fresh components. They'll do a good couple of races. Cause if you remember the end of last season, I started having to put old parts on. So those newer components will help. That should get us up to spec 2. We'll be able to afford them. We've got about 40 days and we're making about 2 million a race, so we'll be fine. But yeah, activities. I keep forgetting about the activities. Yeah, durability, that's what we want. We'll just get that out the way.
Okay, we've had the new parts come through the fabrication process. We'll have them with us for the next Grand Prix.
Okay. Yeah, so... when's fab? It must be after the race. Now we can try and get some durability upgrades. Yeah, you can see durability is the lowest right now. Powertrain, we'll get that hopefully soon. But anyway, that's going to be it for today. Hope you enjoyed the Monaco Grand Prix. I didn't. When we come back next time, we'll be at Baku. I'm a bit better at Baku. Bit better. We'll get new components as well, so that'll help us. But anyway, yeah, I'll catch you all next time. At least our teammate won. At least we got some points in the constructors. I'll catch you next time for the Baku Grand Prix. Take care. Goodbye for now.